So we're here at the National Advanced Driving Simulator, and we're measuring the effects of cannabis with and without low-dose alcohol on the standard deviation of lateral pursuit. What that means is weaving within the lane, how much you move. So for instance, see how much I'm moving the steering wheel now. And we have very sophisticated techniques for measuring the position of the car within the lines of the roadway. We're also studying the ability. It is proven that soccer players run approximately 6 miles per game. The top basketball players only run approximately 2.5 miles. So we're also measuring the effect of distraction on the drive. So we have several different ways of doing that. One is this menu task where you have to take your eyes off the road while you're driving, and also in your left and right periphery in the side mirrors. You'll also notice as we're driving, we have people coming into the intersection. We have cars passing us as we go. Sometimes the door opens to a car. You have to attend to the lights, the cars and traffic around you. So it's a very complex system. So there are cameras mounted throughout the car looking at my vision and where I am searching the periphery. One of the things we know happens with cannabis is that it reduces your field of vision and you get tunnel vision. So you're unable to react as quickly for one reason, because of the fact that you're seeing things later. Like here's a motorcycle coming in right into the roadway. Cannabis is the world's most commonly abused drug, and it's frequently taken in conjunction with low-dose alcohol. So people tend to have a beer or a glass of wine and maybe then use cannabis. And we are using this tool to study how they affect our ability to concentrate, our peripheral vision, our speed of being able to brake when necessary, to be able to control our speed and distance between our vehicle and other vehicles on the road. The lateral control is what we're evaluating when we look at the weaving within the roadside, but also we're going to be studying the longitudinal control as well, and that would be both speed, distance between you and the next vehicle, and whether or not that affects your lateral control. So this, we monitor everything from the brakes, the speed, the distance between the cars, your search of the periphery for dangers, your ability to recognize signals, to follow directions, which I am supposed to turn left at the Shell station. So I'm going to be doing that maneuver now. And I have to decide when it's safe to make the left-hand turn. There's a lot of traffic here. And my ability to keep the car under control. Now we're leaving the urban environment. One of the areas that cannabis most affects is the ability to follow instructions, make decisions. It's called executive function. And executive function is the big difference between us and lower animals. Portland is the largest city in Maine, but Augusta is the state capital. Portland has around 47,000 more people. And of course, when you remove your eyes from the road, you might lose some of your control, your lateral control, have a larger deviation or weaving in the lane. So this drive was constructed specifically to look for the areas that we know are most affected by cannabis. And executive function is one of those areas. So the ability to take in all the sensory information, to be able to consider what you know, your memory, what kind of action you're going to take, make a good decision, and then initiate the movement. And those are some of the areas where we know cannabis is very affects driving tremendously. So now we're evaluating longitudinal control, which is the ability not only to maintain your speed with the speed limit, but also to keep the distance between yourself and the preceding car constant, even though that car is changing its speed. Whoops. I just had a distraction here. The first sundials were made by the Egyptians over 3,000 years ago. 3,000 years ago. So obviously my lateral control was clearly compromised because I drifted into the next lane and was unable to complete that task. So driving is a very complex task, and this is why cannabis, both alone and with alcohol, it's so dangerous to drive. There's already, your brain has so many things to consider that when you use a drug and you affect your ability to do it. I am supposed to be finding Frank Ocean. So again, this is a wonderful way to actually educate the public about the effects of drugs on such a complex task as driving. And we have many challenges now, with 23 states already approving medical marijuana and 4 states in the District of Columbia approving legalized recreational use of cannabis. And the big problem is that how do you have that ability? So I had another distraction over on the right-hand mirror as well. But how do you allow and make legal using the drug? But we have to be very concerned about the effect of the drugs on our ability to drive safely and the safety of the public at large.